chemical bond. A chemical bond is a force of attraction between atoms, ions, molecules that leads to the formation of chemical compounds, the chemical bonds. Do you know atoms? In between atoms, there will be a force of attraction or repulsion. In between ions, there will be a force of attraction and repulsion. Molecules, in between the molecules, there is a force of attraction and repulsion, and hence the formation of chemical bonds are formed between atoms, ions, and molecules. So therefore, the chemical bond occurs because of the sharing of electrons. Today, let us discuss about the sharing of electrons, how the electrons are sharing in between the atoms, how the electrons are sharing in between the ions, and how the electrons are sharing in between the molecules. Well, friends, let us have a brief discussion about the theory involved in the chemical bond formation. The chemical bond is the lasting attraction between atoms, ions, and molecules, as we are discussing today, that enables the formation of chemical compounds. The bond may be result from the electrostatic force of attraction or repulsion between oppositely charged ions, as in ionic bonds, or through the sharing of electrons, as in covalent bonds. The strength of chemical bonds varies considerably. There are strong bonds or primary bonds, such as covalent, ionic, metallic bonds. That means the strong bonds or primary bonds takes place in covalent, ionic, and metallic bonds. Other category, weak bonds or secondary bonds, such as dipole-dipole interactions, the London dispersion force, and hydrogen bonding. Since opposite charges attract via the simple electromagnetic force, the negativity charged electrons that are orbiting the nucleus and the positively charged protons in the nucleus attract each other. An electron positions between the two nuclei will be attracted to both of them, and the nuclei will be attracted towards the electrons in this position. This attraction constitutes the chemical bond. The attraction between atoms, the attraction between ions, the attraction between molecules together constitutes the formation of chemical bond. Due to the matter wave nature of electrons, under smaller mass, they must occupy a larger amount of volume compared with the nuclei. And this volume occupied by the electrons keeps the atomic nuclei in a bond relatively far apart as compared with the size of the nuclei. In general, strong chemical bonding is associated with the sharing of or transfer of electrons between the participating atoms. Between the participating atoms in the sense during the combination of the two atoms. The atoms in molecules, crystals, metals, and diatomic gases, indeed most of physical environment around us, are held together by chemical bonds which dictate the structure and the bulk properties of matter. This is all about the introduction to the formation of chemical bond, my dear friends, and hence structure, bonding, and properties. There are three types: metal, metal and non-metal, and non-metals. Metallic bond, ionic bond, and covalent bond are the important chemical bonds what we are discussing today. Well, the ionic bond is electron transfers of electrons. So just recollect the memory of ionic bond. And today is covalent bond, that is sharing between the two atoms, ions, or molecules. The sharing of the two atoms, polar covalent bonds, polar and covalent bonds, you know, non-polar. Polar and non-polar, very important is that what is meant by polarity and what is meant by non-polarity. Polarity is nothing but the developed small positive charge and small negative charge between the unequal sharing of electrons. That is unequal sharing of electrons. There is an equal sharing of electrons in case of non-polar covalent bond. There is an unequal sharing of electrons between the polar, unequal sharing of the electrons. Therefore, equal sharing of electrons in the non-polar. But unequal sharing of electrons is polar. That is the polarity. Polarity means the charges of equal charges in between two electrons. Suppose there is a different types of molecules or charges or ions, there will be a different charge. The amount of charge differs. Therefore, they are unequal sharing of electrons. This is the study of polar covalent bond. But in case of ionic bond, there is no sharing of electrons. Only the transferring of electrons will take place. Very important concept. Try to remember, my dear friends, this is very important, polarity and non-polarity. Well, in this class today, chemistry, that is physical chemistry, nature of chemical bond and the formation of covalent bonds. The important thing is that, during the sharing of electrons located in the space between the two nuclei are called bonding electrons. What are bonding electrons? There are some sort of electrons in between the space. The bonded pair is the glue that holds the atoms together in molecular units. Well, explain the formation of chemical bond. According to Kossel and Lewis, the two great persons, the two great scientists, Walther Kossel, 1888 to 1956, and Mr. Gilbert N. Lewis, 1875 to 1946, these two scientists are responsible for the explanation of the formation of chemical bond. Poisson's rule is also important. This is a rule that every ionic bond, there is always some percentage covalent character. That's covalent, that is anion and cations, positively charged ion and negatively charged ion. The polarizing power increases and thus the covalent character increases. Similarly for anion, if its charge is higher and size is also larger, then the polarizability, that is, increases and thus the covalent character increases. It is nothing but the covalent character increases when the different types of charges combines together during the formation of a chemical bond. For example, hydrogen combines with hydrogen. Hydrogen atom combines with hydrogen atom. Here, the sharing of electrons taking place between the two atoms of hydrogen gives hydrogen molecule. That's why the bond between the hydrogen and hydrogen atom is nothing but covalent bond, because sharing of electrons.